the reason we're here today is we're actually putting a heritage marker on the engine on behalf of Engineering Heritage Australia, but also the American Society of Engineers are putting a marker on the putting an international marker to celebrate the Chaffey irrigation scheme both here and in Renmark. And we've just heard during this week that the Institute of Mechanical Engineers in England are also going to put a marker on the actual engine itself next year.
What is perhaps unique about Mildura and Renmark is the fact that pretty much the complete system has survived. We've got the pumping plant like this. We've got channels still as they were, pretty much as they were originally built. We've got a whole town that was largely town planned, and a lot of the public buildings were built during that early development era, and they've all pretty much all survived. That might be close to unique.
Pump station here at Psyche Pumps, looked after by St Regis Steam Preservation Society. And that's a group of fellows that were originally involved with the restoration. And that took about 8 years, from 1990 to 1998, to get it back into working order. And those fellows are driven by their love of machinery, the love of steam, but also a desire to see our heritage maintained.
If you'd have saw what it was when we started, there was no way you'd have said it would ever work. But they did. And today is a testament to what it is. That it's, and especially today with all these engineers here, that they can see what we've achieved and what Chaffey achieved. They were, well, George himself was a man far before his time for what he did. To come here and have a look at the river and say, okay, the water's down there, I want it up there, I'll design and build an engine and a pump to get the water up there so that we can irrigate.
It was the first of its kind in the world at that time, and it built on what was steam used in ships particularly, but he configured it to set up as a land-based pumping system, and that's really what the uniqueness of this site is about.
It was a triple expansion engine, which meant that the steam was generated at fairly high pressure and was then expanded in three cylinders in succession at progressively lower pressures in order to get the most energy out of the steam.
It was the actual crankshafts themselves are actually out of balance, or out of balance in the fact of the loading. And Tangies, who actually built the engine, weren't confident that his design would actually work. It turned out in the end that one of the crankshafts actually broke. They replaced it with another crankshaft from Tangies, and it broke again. So Chaffey's designed their own crankshaft and had it built in Australia, and that one's still in the engine. The Chaffey engine here is unique to Mildura.
Their combined skills allowed them to integrate engineering, social, commercial and agricultural techniques to develop irrigation colonies in very aggressive environments. Self-taught engineer George Chaffey pushed the limits of the use of centrifugal pumps to achieve efficient, high-volume pumping at affordable costs for irrigation work. William Benjamin pioneered dried fruit processing and winemaking and helped to establish Australian excellence in those industries.
We are so excited about this wonderful announcement, and of course a recognition that the Psyche Pumps have not only just gained nationally by this recognition, but internationally. And what that means for the Chaffey Trail is that it brings a major component of the Chaffey Trail now out to the world.
And when you look around Mildura, what they have achieved is just amazing. People don't realise what they've actually done, the layout of the town, the engineering, the pumps and all the engineering achievements of George and William are just amazing.
William Benjamin was my great-grandfather, and I think he'd be incredibly proud to see what he achieved and where it's turned out today, especially if you looked outside of Mildura and looked at the whole irrigation industry right throughout Australia.
If the Chaffeys hadn't have came and somebody else had come along, would have this all been possible, or would it be like this? Would it be worse off? Would it be as good? I suppose that would be the big question. Would it be like it is now?
Well, what would have happened if they hadn't come out? What would this place be? Would Mildura exist? Wouldn't it exist as it is today?
They were leaders, they were far-sighted, very much so in their day, and they faced a lot of difficulties. In fact, WB went broke, George went back to California and started a bank, but they persevered, and it's got what we've got around us today.
I'm incredibly proud. I mean, you don't wake up every day thinking you're a descendant of the Chaffey, but when you go to something like this, or when I was growing my grapes, you realise and you are very proud.